Yes, dear students, in the previous video we have started the classification of polymers. In that we have covered the two parts. First, that is on the basis of monomers, and in the second, on the basis of molecular structure. On the basis of monomers, we have covered two parts, that is the homopolymer and another is the copolymer. Homopolymer, when monomers are identical types, means all the monomers are same, identical, similar types, that time we are going to call it as a homopolymer. Copolymer means monomers are the monomers which are present in the polymer, they are different type, that we are going to call as a copolymer. Okay, so this is on the basis of monomer. Second, on the basis of molecular structure, that also we have covered in the previous video. So there are the two types depending upon its structure. One is a linear. Linear means, here in linear structure, monomer having only two side linkages there, and another type, that is the cross link or network like, here monomer having the three side linkage. Okay, and because of three side linkage, they are going to form the network like or cross link structure they are going to form. Okay, so in this video we are going to cover on the basis of thermal behavior, that is on the basis of thermal behavior, polymers are two types. One is thermosoftening polymer and another is thermosetting polymer. So let us proceed for that. Okay. On the basis of thermal behavior, there are two types. First is thermosoftening plastic, means thermosoftening polymer. These are the polymers that soften on heating and harden on cooling reversibly, are known as thermoplast. Okay, this thermosoftening plastic, it is also called the thermoplastic. Means what? The plastic thermosoftening name itself indicates. Thermo means heat, soft means on heating which becomes the soft, and on cooling it becomes the hard. That polymer you are going to call as a thermosoftening plastic or thermosoftening polymer. Okay, so such polymers, they are having generally linear structure. Okay, they becomes the soft when you are going to heat it, and they, on cooling, they are going to regain their original size. Okay, so that's what it is called, the thermosoftening. By heating you can make it soft, you can reshape and reuse it also. Okay, so therefore such polymers can be reshaped on reheating. These are soluble in organic solvents as their molecular bonds are weaker. Okay, here their molecular bond is weaker. Thermosoftening plastics are formed by addition polymerization. Remember, we are going to cover the types of polymerization. So there are the two types of polymerization, addition and condensation. So this thermosoftening plastic, it is obtained by which type of polymerization? It is obtained by the addition polymerization. And the examples of this thermosoftening polymer or thermosoftening plastic is polyethylene, PVC, Teflon, polystyrene. These are the examples of that thermosoftening plastic. Okay. Next, thermosetting plastic. So thermosetting, name itself indicate. Set means once it is set, when you are going to heat it, it is not going to become this soft. That's why it is called the thermosetting plastic. Okay, so polymers which cannot be softened on heating are known as thermosetting polymer or thermosetting plastics. Okay, such polymers, they are generally cross-link structure. Okay, these polymers, they are having the cross-link structure. These polymers cannot be reshaped and reused. Like previous one, thermosoftening, as you are going to make it soft, so you can give it any shape, that desired shape that you want. But here, they are not going to become the soft on heating. So, they cannot be reclaimed again from their waste. But where in previous case, in thermosoftening, they can be reclaimed from their waste. So, it can be reused. But here, thermosetting plastics, they cannot be reshaped and reused. Okay. They are insoluble in some organic solvent. They are insoluble means, like your alcohols or any esters, acetone wagere, in that it is a insoluble. Okay, because they are having strong bond. Okay, here there is a three side linkage is present. Cross link structure means monomer having the three side linkage, that's why it is going to form the cross link structure or network like structure. Okay, thermosetting plastics are formed by the condensation polymerization. Okay, thermosetting plastic, they are formed by the condensation polymerization, and previous one it is by the addition polymerization. So example of that thermosetting, it is the bakelite, nylon 66, these are the examples of thermosetting plastic. Okay, so let us see the difference between these two, thermosoftening plastic and thermosetting plastic. Okay, thermosoftening, it is also called the thermoplastic. Okay, first they are formed by the addition polymerization, whereas they are formed by the condensation polymerization. They consist of linear chain polymer. Here the structure is the linear chain, and whereas in thermosetting its structure is cross-linked, three-dimensional network-like structure is here. Okay, here polymer chain are held by the weak van der Waals forces, whereas here they are linked together by the strong covalent bond. Okay, here in thermoplastic they are the weak, soft and less brittle. Here they are the strong, hard and more brittle. I would like to give you the example. Take the example of polythene, polyethylene. It is the weak, polythene bags. Okay, it is weak but it is soft and less brittle. Okay, khali padla tar te futat vagere nahi, because it is a less brittle. अच्छा उलट तुम्ही थर्मोसेटिंगचं एक्झाम्पल आपलं प्रेशर कुकरचे हँडल असतील किंवा आयर्नचे जे हँडल आहेत त्याचं जर एक्झाम्पल घेतलं तर कसे आहेत ते स्ट्रॉंग, हार्ड बट मोर ब्रिटिल. जर खाली पडलं तर ते काय होतं, फुटतात, बिकॉज दे आर दी मोर ब्रिटिल. ओके, नेक्स्ट थर्मोप्लास्टिक, दे आर सॉफ्टन ऑन हीटिंग अँड हार्डन ऑन कूलिंग, वेर एज इन थर्मोसेटिंग दे डू नॉट सॉफ्टन ऑन हीटिंग. दे कॅन बी रिमोल्डेड. हिअर thermosoftening or thermoplastic, it can be remold, reused, reclaimed, but they cannot be remolded or reclaimed here in thermosetting. Okay, here they are having low molecular weights. Here they are having the low molecular weights, but in thermosetting they are having the high molecular weights. They are soluble in organic solvent. They are soluble in organic solvent, whereas here they are the insoluble, they are not going to dissolve in the organic solvent. So this is about the third type, depending on the thermal behavior, that is thermosetting and thermosoftening, that we have covered here. Next part that we are going to start, that is the polymerization. Polymerization, what is polymerization? The process of formation of polymer, it is called the polymerization. This part we are going to cover in the next video. Till then, thank you.